Racing to the 2021 Breeders' Cup, and this time let's get an update for Saturday, October the 16th. We're getting closer to November 5th and 6th and the Breeders' Cup. Wanted to give you a quick update on the latest contenders that are in and out, some workouts. We're recording this during Champions Day. It is right around 9 o'clock Central Time in the morning. And let's take a look at the latest news, including Breeders' Cup bound horses, and some of the lineups are starting to change already. We've got Rattle N Roll, the winner of the Breeders' Cup Futurity at Keeneland last week. There was some talk that he was going to pass on the Breeders' Cup, but now Ken McPeak is saying that they are kind of thinking of going to the Breeders' Cup. I think a couple of obvious reasons. He's in good form. He can come from off the pace. There seems to be some speed in that race with Jack Christopher and Pinehurst and Corniche. Also, when they're going good, it's a grade one, and also it's a big purse, and, you know, I think there's a few question marks on a few of those speed horses. Can they get a mile in the 16th? Major General was going to point to the Breeders' Cup Juvenile. He is now out for trainer Todd Pletcher. Happy Saver has not worked in a month. More than likely he is out. They were going to still try to get a workout in him and see where his conditioning is, but I just can't see him making the race, especially after missing a full month of workouts. California Angel wins her way in via Keeneland, the Jessamine Trust, on Wednesday, so she's going to point to the Breeders' Cup turf on the juvenile side. And then Ivar and In Love, it looks like they're both came out of their race last week well at Keeneland, the mile, and they're going to point for the Breeders' Cup turf mile for Paul Lobo, who does very well, In Love and good form, and I think already some chatter that Ivor could make a dent in that race. He ran a huge race last year at Keeneland, and a mile is his best distance. It could be a live long shot on Breeders' Cup day. Also, we've got Dubawi Legend. He was second in the Dewhurst Stakes, and looks like he is going to come on over and point for the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Turf. That'll be a good distance for him on Future Stars Friday. Latruska, no talk of her going to the Classic. It's going to be 100% the Breeders' Cup distaff unless a lot of that field drops out of the Classic. So Latruska going to try to cap off her, definitely she's older, filly and mare. And still a chance of Horse of the Year if something weird happens in the Classic. Latruska, a good old school fashion campaign, 4 grade 1 wins on the year. She's won at multiple distances. She's won at different tracks. And she always brings her A game to the races. 16 for 21 lifetime. Dr. Post, he is now out of the Classic. They're going to point more for the Cigar Mile with him. I thought, you know, some people liked him closing in some of those races, but he never really was a mile and a quarter type horse. I think he was going to take a little bit of money just because some people thought he could close into all that speed, but he's just not a mile and a quarter horse, and I really don't think he's a grade one horse. They can try to run him in that Cigar Mile. I just don't know if he's going to pick up a grade one in that spot. Jasper Great. This horse is interesting. He ran in Japan. He's a two-year-old. He won his first start by 10 lengths on the dirt. He is going to come over and participate in that Breeders' Cup Juvenile. He is by Arrogate, and of course, Arrogate died, so he's not going to have a lot of foals to the races here over, I think he's got 3 crops that are going to hit. This is his first crop, and Jasper Great adds a little bit of intrigue and could be a nice price in that Breeders' Cup Juvenile. You add him, you add Rattle N Roll, and then you've got Jack Christopher, Corniche, and Pinehurst. That's a pretty solid 5, Papa Cap in there. It might only be an 8-9 horse field, but I think it's going to give you some options to go different ways. Workout report on Saturday and Friday. Medina Spirit went 5 furlongs out west for trainer Bob Baffert. Echo Zulu is already out in California. She worked out for trainer Steve Asmussen. She's definitely going to be the favorite in that Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies. Echo Zulu, 5 furlongs on Friday. Gamin, 6 furlongs and 112. A short field lining up for the Breeders' Cup Filly and Mare Sprint. Looks like it's going to be Gamin against Bella Sophia, and Belle's the 1, and Cece are the main 4 combatants in that one. And trainer John Sadler confirming Flagstaff pointing for the Breeders' Cup Sprint. He ran a pretty good race against Dr. Shivel in the Santa Anita Sprint Championship. Of course, Jackie's Warrior going to be favored in that one. But again, I think that race is going to come up very competitive. The Breeders' Cup Sprint, always one of my, probably my second favorite race on the card besides the Breeders' Cup Classic year in and year out. Hot Rod Charlie worked out last week with the French blinkers. Still talk of him wearing those for the Classic. We'll see what he does. He's supposed to work out Saturday or Sunday for his next workout. Essential quality working out early. He likes to get up early and get out of bed on Saturday mornings and get his workouts in. He continues to work out with Colonel Bowman. Colonel Bowman going to be the biggest underlay in history, as people like to read those workout reports. And Knicks Go, he got a nice workout after that Lucas Classic in. Just a very slow, take it easy workout. First work back, 4 furlongs. So basically he's pointing towards that Breeders' Cup Classic. And he's still kind of the favorite online in the overseas betting, although I think it's going to be very close between him and Essential Quality for the actual Breeders' Cup Classic favorite in that race. Stiletto Boy also pointing to the Breeders' Cup Classic and Tripoli, and that means we've really got about 10 to 11 horses for that Classic division. Essential Quality and Max Player. Max Player been working out west for Steve Asmussen. Knicks Go, Tripoli. Idle going to point to that race now. Medina Spirit, Art Collector after winning that Woodward, and then Maxfield and Stiletto Boy. Maybe one or two other horses could get up to 12 horse field, but definitely 10. Express Train is one of those horses still considering the Breeders' Cup Classic. That's your report for Saturday, October the 16th. We're going to have another one on Sunday. Then we're going to start previewing the races. We've got the Juvenile Fillies on Monday, the Sprint, and then also the Dirt Mile still to come. As we keep you up to date on the Breeders' Cup, let me know your thoughts. This is your chance to tell me who you like in some of these races, comment on the contenders in some of the leading divisions, and what are some of the key factors you're looking at. Remember, smash that like button as we continue to get you ready for the Breeders' Cup 2021.